What's up, everybody? Once again, it's Brandman Sean, and I'm back with another episode of Inside the Network, where we show exclusive content from inside of BrandmanNetwork.com. Now, this is another clip from our collaboration, Brandman Network Group, with Music Entrepreneur Club, where me and Dame are asking questions. In this particular clip, we're talking about, do artists still need websites? Why is it relevant, or is it not relevant at all? Check out this breakdown right here. Dame does a good job at sharing what the whole path looks like
right now. But my first question was, I was watching this Adam Ivey video, and he talked about creating your own website. And he was saying, like, because social media is so congested and because it's controlled by someone else, it's hard to really promote and push your brand and your music on those platforms. And I wanted to get you guys' take on, like, creating your own website and, like, sending your traffic towards that website.
Damn, you want to answer first?
Yeah, no, I definitely feel like you got, I know that there's been some chatter, like, you don't need a website, stuff like that. I'm not in that camp. I definitely feel like you should have a website. I definitely feel like you should strive to own the communication with your fans. And this actually might be a good point to share the graphic that I put together to see if it makes sense to you guys. Let me see if I can share my screen. Can you guys see this?
Yep. Viewer screen, like, yeah, comment. Yeah.
All right. So this is what I call the journey of a fan. And I'll show you how it kind of relates to what you're talking about. So this is essentially what you guys are tasked with, right? Like getting that first initial view or stream and then trying to take them through this cycle to eventually spending money. So on this graphic, what you see at each step, there's a higher likelihood that that person would spend money. So on one side, you have a view or a stream. I mean, somebody could have clicked the button on accident. At this point, you don't even know if they liked it or didn't like it, right? It's just a view or a stream. It's a pretty weak metric and a pretty weak indicator that, you know, this person's gonna spend money. But as you move to the right, like, comment, follow, they're doing more things that prove that they like your content. They support what you're doing. But when you get to the green is an indicator that you actually start owning this communication. And this is why it's important, right? Because if you get somebody to give you an email, and especially if somebody gives you their phone number, there's a super high likelihood that they're going to spend money with you. And that is why I think Adam's talking about a website and having a place where you own the communication and is so important. Because if somebody gives me their phone number, that means they trust me enough. That means they love what I do enough to give me that phone number, because not everybody wants to be bothered with a text or a phone call, right? So I can assume that pretty much, I would bet that if somebody gives you their phone number to interact with them or to get a video via text or any type of marketing via text, this is just a wild guess, but I would assume that 75% of those people will actually spend money. 80% will actually spend money, because again, a phone number is a pretty intimate thing. This again is essentially the journey, and sometimes this takes years, right? From that initial view or stream all the way through to actually spending money. You guys need to understand that sometimes this is a year process, sometimes it's a week process, maybe a couple of days process. You don't know, but you know, and this is why I'm always emphasizing the importance of getting phone numbers. If you have people that you feel like you've at least taken all the way through to like the share email stage and you're comfortable asking for their phone number, you guys should be getting the phone numbers of your fans. And this graphic hopefully indicates exactly why. It's because it's right before, you know, essentially spending money. It doesn't necessarily happen in this order, but it's a higher likelihood that they're going to spend money. So going back to your question, yes, definitely have a website. Definitely be getting emails, definitely be getting phone numbers if you've already built up relationships to a point where they trust you enough to give you a phone number, because that is when you can more easily create experiences for your fans and monetize your fan base as well. And a lot of this happens on our websites. So I work with you know, I work with Futuristic and I work with a couple of comedians and actors, and on their websites, we're trying to get phone numbers and emails there as well. I mean, I still do emails, but email open rates are pretty low. It can be effective. Email can still be effective, but open rates are pretty low. The phone numbers, however, when you start texting with your fans, the open rates are like 95-96%. And that's, again, another reason why I would put the phone number ahead of an email. But a lot of people still swear by emails. A lot of people still monetizing their email lists. And that's what happens on your website. And also what happens on your website, you sell merch. Hopefully you got a cool merch strategy. You got some cool items. So you always want to send traffic because you're monetizing right then and there. So hopefully this makes sense. I'm still not 100% comfortable with how it looks, because I know that if I wasn't there to explain it, a lot of people would be like, what the fuck is this? So I'm probably going to massage it a little bit and put some more explanations in it.
I have some feedback for the design if you want to hear it.
For sure.
Yeah, I would suggest making the...
All right, so that's that clip. And of course, you can check out the full clip in brandmannetwork.com. But I want to give my opinion and just expanding on why I think websites are still relevant, but how they should be used. One, they're still relevant because all of these assets are still relevant in some form or fashion. Email, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, TV, radio, all these things are just mediums, right, to communicate, create awareness, and or capture. Now, I put website on the back end, capture. Yes, websites were cool to have and try to get people to it. And, you know, you want to do all these experiences and things like that back in the day. But now it's less about trying to get them to spend time on your website or even direct them to do all these things and showing them your music and all that. It's more about having a utility to your website. It's more about having a purpose for your website. And what I mean by that is, don't just try to mimic your Instagram page, or don't try to get people to listen to your music on your website, any of that kind of stuff, right? For your website, you should really be looking at three primary things. One, opt-in. By opt-in, that means collect some information. You should have something for them to sign up for, whatever excuse there is for them to give you their information. That's the number one purpose that you should be looking at your website for, because you want to own as much data so you can get back to them for cheap or free versus all these other social networks. Two, then something to sell, right? That could be merch or whatever makes sense for your brand. And then three is a little bit more open, but something like touring or some kind of updates like that. Okay, cool. Right? Something that's very specific information where you're probably not going to have a full expansion on social media, or it just makes it easier for it to be in one place, right? Tour and ticket sales, but that kind of runs back into sales, right? Or something for people to buy. So purpose number one, if you have anything, just an opt-in, right? If you had to choose one thing, just something for them to opt in. Two, buy something, some sort of product, right? Something for you to make money in, which is almost still some version of an opt-in, but you probably need a funnel created or attached to that, more purpose. And then last but not least, tour. So that's my thoughts, just generally speaking. Of course, it could slightly differ from some situation to situation, but that opt-in thing is very serious. Almost all around, I'm pretty much going to probably give that same advice. So again, if you want to check out this full interview, well, this full conversation, brandmannetwork.com is a place to do that. Also to help get information to build your brand, develop your brand, and really help build your fan base. But of course, as always, we end it here. If you like this video, go ahead hit the like button. If you like it, then you might as well share it. And if you're not subscribed, you know what to do. Hit that subscribe.